Hello everyone, welcome to one more video of special BIO-TONIC. Students, in this video we'll discuss about the structure of a dicot stem. Students, this section mainly consists of epidermis, cortex and steel. Epidermis is the outermost layer. Cortex is made up of hypodermis, parenchymatous cortex and endodermis. The steel is with pith, vascular bundle and pericycle. Now let us see the details one by one. Students, the epidermis is the outermost layer. It is covered by cuticle. It may also show stomata. This epidermis shows multicellular structures called epidermal hairs or trichomes. The layer between the epidermis and pericycle is called cortex. Students, these are the cells which are compactly arranged and intercellular spaces are filled with pectin. It is called hypodermis. It gives mechanical support to the plant body. Below hypodermis, we can see chlorenchymatous cells which help in photosynthesis, which is followed by loosely arranged parenchymatous cells. These parenchymatous cells store starch. The innermost layer of the cortex is called endodermis. It contains barrel-shaped, compactly arranged cells. It is also called starch sheath. Layers below cortex is called steel. This steel mainly consists of central pith, vascular bundle, which is surrounded by pericycle. Students, the pericycle is made up of sclerenchymatous cell, which forms the cap-like structure around the vascular bundles. In case of dicot plants, the vascular bundle shows phloem on the outer side, xylem on the inner side, which is separated by cambium. So such a vascular bundle is called cojoint, collateral and open. Students, the cells between the vascular bundles are called medullary rays. These cells help in lateral conduction. The central part of the stem is occupied by parenchymatous tissue. It is called pith. So students, I hope you are clear with the structure of dicot stem. Now, this dicot stem differs from monocot stem with respect to the following features. In case of dicot plants, the epidermal hairs are present, which are absent in case of monocot plants. Hypodermis in case of monocot plants is made up of sclerenchyma. Vascular bundles are numerous and scattered in the ground tissue. Each vascular bundle is surrounded by sclerenchymatous bundle of sheath. Vascular bundles are cojoint, collateral and closed type. So remember here, there is no cambium between xylem and phloem. So therefore, in case of monocot plant, secondary growth is absent. Xylem shows lysigenous cavity, which is a peculiar feature of monocot plant. Pith is absent. So students, I hope you are clear with the structure of dicot stem as well as monocot stem. Again, I request you all to like my channel, share it and subscribe it. Thank you.